All right, 6-3, proving quadrilaterals are parallelograms. Good stuff here, good stuff. So now it's kind of like looking at the converse of these things, okay? So if they give you a quadrilateral, okay, and they tell you that the opposite sides are congruent, then we can say it is a parallelogram. Okay, if they give you a quadrilateral, a four-sided figure, where the opposite angles are congruent, then we can say that it's a parallelogram. If they give you a quadrilateral, okay, where they say, let's say they said A, B, C, D, where A plus B, I should put angle A plus angle B equals 180, and I say angle B plus angle C equals 180, and I say angle C plus angle D equals 180, and I say angle A plus angle D equals 180, then that figure is a parallelogram. If they give us, it's like the converse, guys. Remember the converse? We switch the part, the if and the then part. That's kind of what we're dealing with here, okay? So A, B, C, D, they give you a quadrilateral, a four-sided figure, where the diagonals bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. Okay? Now, they're going to have proofs in this section, okay? They're going to have proofs, and they have the proofs that I like. I love these proofs, okay? They're not two-column proofs. I'm not going to really worry about the two-column proofs in this section, okay? So we want to prove quadrilaterals are parallelograms. So these are the ways that we can do that, okay? Ways to prove a quadrilateral is a parallelogram. We could show opposite angles are congruent. We could show consecutive angles are supplementary. We could show the diagonals bisect each other. Okay. We could show opposite sides are congruent. Okay. So, you know, we've got all our properties here. That's kind of what we're feeding from here. We can show, talk about the definition right now. Okay, we're going to talk about the definition. Show opposite sides are parallel. And then there's this one thing here, okay? This one little property which combines a couple of these. Show one pair of sides, one pair of opposite sides is congruent and parallel, okay? You pick one pair of opposite sides, show that they're congruent, and show that they're also parallel. So here's what the proofs are gonna look like. It's gonna say something like this. Show that A, which is 2, negative 1, B, which is 1, 3, C, which is 6, 5, and D, which is 7, 1, are the vertices of a parallelogram. Okay? So my advice to you to do these problems, the first thing you need to do is you need to draw a picture. So A is 2, negative 1. 1, 2, negative 1, that's down there, that's A. B, over 1, up 3. 1, 2, 3, that's B. C, 6, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, there's C. And then D is 7, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. Okay. Okay, so what do you think? Now we have to do this. It says show. We can't say, oh, it, you know, it looks like that. No. And when we're looking at these are the ones we're going to concentrate on. We want to show either opposite sides are congruent, show opposite sides are parallel, or show one pair of sides is both congruent and parallel. My suggestion to you, okay, my suggestion to you is that you stick with one of these two. If you like the slope formula, then do the parallel one. If you like the distance formula, then do the congruent one. So, I am gonna do, I'll do it both ways. So the first one, I'm gonna show that BC is parallel to AD, and then that AB is parallel to CD. Okay, I've got to do both of those. All right, show both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. So again, it doesn't take me very long. You guys can time me, get your little stopwatches out, how long it takes me to write these points down. Okay, ready, go. 1, 3, 6, 5. 2, -1, 7, 1. I don't know how long that took me, probably about 6, 7, 8 seconds. It's worth it, trust me. Now my slope formula is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay, difference of my y's, difference of my x's. So I'm gonna have 5 minus 3 over 6 minus 1. So I get 2 over 5. And over here I'm gonna do 1 minus a negative 1 on the top, and then I'm gonna do 7 minus 2. And it looks like I got 2/5. Okay, checks off there. Looking good so far, looking good. All right. So let's look, AB, ready? 2, -1, 1, 3. CD, 6, 5, 7, 1. Okay, do the slopes again. 3 minus a -1, 3 minus -1 over 7 minus 2. 3 plus 1 is 4. That looks like it's 4/5. I'm sorry, I copied that wrong. That's a 1. So it should be 1 minus 2. So it's 4 over a negative 1. Sorry, can't read my own writing. It's a problem. And then over here, 1 minus 5 over 7 minus 6. And I get negative 4 over 1, negative 4 over 1. We do this with a finishing sentence if you want full credit. Since BC is parallel to AD and AB is parallel to CD, ABCD is a parallelogram. All right? Now, that's one way. I think the slope formula is easier than the distance formula. You don't have to worry about square roots. You don't have to worry about that stuff. But you know what? You can do it the other way, okay? So I'm gonna leave this right here. I'm gonna make this big line down. And you can include this in your notes. I would, okay? Now my distance formula is the difference of my x's squared plus the difference of my y's squared. Okay, so let's do that. 6 minus 1 squared, 5 minus 3 squared. 6 minus 1 is 5, 5 squared is 25, 5 minus 3 is 2, 2 squared is 4. So that's gonna be the square root of 29. So I'm hoping that this is gonna be the same thing, that this is gonna be the square root of 29. Okay, so let's look. 1 minus -1 squared. Alexa, skip. 7 minus 2 squared. 2 squared plus 5 squared. Ding, ding, ding. Okay. Sorry, I didn't really leave enough room for you guys to see this that well. Over here, it's going to be 1 minus 2 squared plus 3 minus negative 1. 3 minus negative 1 squared. So that's going to be negative 1 squared is 1. And that's going to be 4 squared is 16. So I get the square root of 17. So after all this, we are hopeful. We are hopeful that this is going to be the square root of 17. 7 minus 6 squared plus 1 minus 5 squared. Well, well, well. What do you know? The square root of 17. Okay? Now you don't have to do both of these. You gotta pick one method. Okay, one method. Now technically you could do this. Take one pair of sides and do the slope and do that. I don't care. Do it. I mean, to me it's easier if you just do all distance formulas, all slope formulas. Okay, easy, good stuff. Good stuff. We like it. Okay, we like it. So now we do our finishing sentence. Since BC is congruent to AD and AB is congruent to CD, ABCD is a parallelogram. All right? That's 6.3, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, that is section 6.3. Hope it made sense.